Cells receive signals from outside via receptors. When a ligand binds to its receptor, a signal is transmitted as part of the signaling cascade, which may alter the function of the cell. A central element of these signaling cascades are protein kinases. Protein kinases are enzymes that transfer a phosphate group onto a target protein, thereby changing protein function from inactive to active. Let's go through this step by step. Protein kinases usually use adenosine triphosphate, in short, ATP, as a source of phosphate. ATP is composed of adenosine and three phosphate groups. Protein kinase binds ATP as well as the target protein and then transfers a phosphate group. The phosphorylated protein and the remaining adenosine diphosphate are subsequently released by protein kinase. Let's take a closer look at the phosphorylated protein. We previously mentioned that phosphorylation leads to the activation of a protein. However, this describes only one out of three possible effects. First, the protein may become activated. Second, the protein may be deactivated. Third, the transferred phosphate group can be a signal to other proteins to interact with the target, thereby passing the signal on. Have you ever wondered how the signal is switched off? Another group of enzymes, the phosphatases, are able to remove the phosphate group from the target protein. Phosphorylation is therefore a reversible protein modification that is regulated by a balance of kinase and phosphatase activity. As you can see, signal transduction through the addition of phosphate groups is a powerful mechanism. Accordingly, the enzymes are kinases with the prefix kin, as in kinetics, meaning to move. Protein kinases are driving forces for many cellular processes, and more than 500 different protein kinases have been identified. All kinases are assigned into a fairly complex system of different groups, families, and subfamilies. This classification takes into account both structure and function. Given the large number of kinases, it is impossible to remember them all. However, you may want to keep in mind that they can be broadly classified according to the amino acid residues they phosphorylate. They usually act on one of three residues: tyrosine, serine, or threonine. However, this comes with a twist. Kinases that are able to transfer phosphate groups to serine residues are also able to do so for threonine residues. Therefore, they are often grouped together as serine-threonine kinases. This leaves us with two large groups: tyrosine kinases and serine-threonine kinases. Regardless of the amino acid residue that is phosphorylated, protein kinases are a central regulatory element of cellular signal transduction.